In a sense, every single security vulnerability comes from a developer making some wrong assumption. Just the difference is, one time, it's just a mistake by the developer to make this assumption, and another time, frameworks do something so strange that it's hard to even blame anyone for not understanding what happened. In this video, I'll show you two examples like this, based on which I created a CTF challenge, which was actually inspired by a real-world $25,000 account takeover on GitHub. Enjoy! When you create a new route in a web application, you usually, regardless of the framework or the programming language, do something like this. You specify the path, you specify the methods, and you specify the function that wants to serve this particular request. Sometimes you may want to create different functions to handle different methods, but you can also handle different methods within the same function, just you have an if statement inside to serve something else for the get, to just serve a static response, and to actually process some parameters and make some changes if the request is post, put, delete, or whatever. Also, the implicit difference that you cannot see here is the CSRF protection. Both GitHub and MyCTF task used middleware to protect against CSRFs, and the way it works is it automatically requires the CSRF token for all post, put, delete, and other requests that are supposed to change something on the server, and the CSRF protection is not required for requests like GET that are only supposed to serve the response. Because of this, even with SameSite None cookies, you couldn't reach this block without a proper CSRF token. If you could, in GitHub, it would allow you to take over the account, and in MyCTF task, you would have to also exploit the XSS, to which I will get later in this video. Just the question is how to do it. And I'll get to answer it in a second, but before I do, I'd like to invite you to take part in this year's CTF organized by my team, Just Cut the Fish. The task I'm showing you is my task from last year. Of course, for this year, I have a new one, and I promise you, it is a fun one, so you should definitely try. And apart from this, my teammates have also prepared amazing, amazing tasks, so you should definitely challenge yourself, because it's an amazing way to develop your hacking skills. The online teaser starts on 15th June and lasts 24 hours. The link is in the description. I'd also like to thank our sponsors Trail of Bits, OtterSec, Hexrace, and SecForce for making it possible. You have links to sponsors in the description, and remember, by checking them out, you support both me and my team. With this said, let's go back to our task. The trick is to use the head method. And you may ask, what head method? We can see in the controller, it's only supposed to root get and post, so how on earth do you get a head method here? But the thing is, a lot of frameworks on the routing stage treat head the same way as they treat get, because the logic is head will be the same thing as get, just the body of the response will be stripped before sending it to the client. So the head method will also be routed to the same function. But at this stage, with this if statement, it is no longer true. At this stage, head and get are separate methods. So if you have an if statement that checks if the method is get, it will also be false for the head method, which means the head method will not require the CSRF protection, yet you can get to this block down there. And yes, we do not have the request body, but the way parameters are processed, it is equivalent to have the request body with a post and to have URL parameters of a head. And this way, you could take over account in GitHub, and in my task, you could change the description where you had to exploit an XSS. And let's now take a look at it, because there is some robust, almost robust sanitization. And this is the code that was used to sanitize the description, and it is quite aggressive. It only allows a few basic tags with no attributes. And to my knowledge, you cannot execute JavaScript code if you cannot use either a script tag or some attribute. But this is not where the mistake was made. The mistake was made a few lines above this. Here, when the code was not parsed, but tokenized. And if you are confused as to what on earth is the difference between tokenizing and parsing, I don't blame you. I also don't blame developers that do not know this difference, because most Stack Overflow answers are confused as well. Well, the difference between tokenizer and a parser with a simple HTML will be none. If you have a simple code like this, the outcome would be the same. But it becomes confusing when you introduce HTML namespaces, because every HTML tag has a namespace. Most of them in most websites that we use are just in the HTML namespace. But within the HTML, you can also embed objects from a math or SVG namespace. And the thing is, the same tag can behave differently in HTML namespace and in SVG namespace. For example, the text area tag in the HTML namespace can only contain text inside. So this code will not work. You can put any XSS payload from the word and it will not execute until you close the text area tag. Because of this, according to the rules I've shown you before, this payload is fine, because even though it looks like so, it does not contain the script tag. It only contains a text that looks like the script tag. But this stops being true when we wrap this in the SVG tag, which changes the namespace. And this is when we finally get to the difference between the tokenizer and the parser. The parser will apply these namespace rules to this and we'll see the script tag being inside. The tokenizer will ignore the namespace, so it will still not see the XSS payload here. The browser, of course, parses our HTML, so this code will look innocent to the sanitizer, but it will execute in the browser, thus giving you the XSS. Once you had this, you could easily exfiltrate the flag, so this would be the final payload that you had to use. Last year, 9 teams found a solution to my task, and if you believe this year you can be one of them, challenge yourself by participating in the CTF. The link is in the description. In the meantime, if you want to check another video with a CTF task, check out my write-up to Live Overflows SQL injection task. The link is on the screen right now. For now, thank you for watching and goodbye.